but she's my shoo-shoo. And she knows that I'm her shoo-shoo. Oba, oba, take my hand now. And we're gonna make the loving samba.
I work for AlmapBBDO as a partner for 25 years. I sold my agency in 1990 and in 2015, and I left the business completely. So that's my short CV. In 1993, my partner and myself, my partner José Luis Madeira, is a planning guy, and I took care of the creative. Alpargatas, Havaianas was the first client that trust us. So at that time, Havaianas was a small brand, was kind of not the major brand of Alpargatas at all. And we started working together. When we found out together in a very symbiotic kind of relationship, we came very close, and then we started discussing the strategy and how to bring new brands to the Alpargatas. And we found out that Havaianas was somewhere under the shelf, so inside a drawer. And it was a brand that had a very important past, but no future at all and no present. It was a very cheap brand. It was the cheapest shoe that you can actually buy in Brazil. So only the people that could afford an Havaianas for work. So Havaianas was really nothing fancy at all. So it was very cheap and was sold in very small places, not even in the city, most in the countryside, most in the northeast of Brazil, and nobody took care of Havaianas. There was no marketing strategy behind Havaianas at that time. So we as an agency, we found out that this brand has an affective memory, what I call its DNA is in somewhere in the Brazilian soul from the scratch, from the 60s, from the 70s, because everybody was using Havaianas at that time, was very successful in the 60s. So people remember somehow that Havaianas is somewhere in the memories from the past, the childhood or teenagers and so on. And it's like, we can use that. Let's use that. So we sat together, and one of the strategies that we developed together was, let's create a new line of products, colorful, beautiful, one single color, the whole sandal, one single color, and make maybe 11 different colors. And let's sell these new Havaianas in fashion shops, in fashion malls, in beautiful small shops in the windows. So beautiful, colorful. And then we start developing a strategy for communicating it. So for the single product, we develop a campaign on TV, using celebrities and making fun of celebrities. Was very funny and full of Brazilian black humor sometimes. And we developed a print campaign for this new product. Then we put on the Vogue magazines, all the fashion magazines in Brazil. So we developed, if you talk about the social pyramid of Brazil, we developed TV for the bottom, and we start on print and the Vogue magazines and Elle or Marie Claire, on the top. And then we talked to everybody. So that's how we started the success of the Havaianas. The social pyramid, basic TV for the masses, and print very sophisticated, colorful, beautiful campaigns on the top. I think the most important secret is success. If you are successful developing the brand, you get the account. Unless you do something stupid. But the second issue is, you have to start the planning and the strategy, the brand strategy, together with the client. You have to be responsible too for the strategy. It's not only that the client have developed a strategy, find out of an agency, okay, just develop it. This is what happens nowadays. At that time, we were responsible for the strategy together with the client. We are sitting together in the same table and developing strategy together. So this symbiotic work started in the beginning from the strategy. So we are responsible for the strategy. So the client is responsible for the developing the executive the creative work and so on, everybody's connected. So if you have this kind of relationship from the beginning, then you, the chances, if you are successful, the chance that you keep the relationship is really good. But what we did is we found out, we had a very good insight inside the agency that the people had this affective memory of the brand. And we can actually talk to this affective memory. We have a huge brand in our hands. And then that's what he did. Working on the TV, we developed a strategy of being very fun, using some celebrities, but making really funny commercials and pulling the leg of the commercial of the celebrities, not taking them seriously. So what's really successful on the base. And on the top, I developed at that time a visual language of the brand. It was very fun, colorful, really iconographic. You never use on the print media. We never use the sandals on the swimming pool on the beach. We made it something really iconic. We make it beautiful and very Brazilian. So when the moment these two, the social pyramid, you have the top and the bottom, start working that direction. And one point they met in the middle. That's when Brazil actually saw Havaianas as a Brazilian brand that was everywhere. So it was nice to wear Havaianas, was great to wear Havaianas in every single social class. So it was all over the place. It was a really, really Brazilian phenomenon. And then what happened was the models at that time, the Brazilian models were very successful. They are still very successful worldwide. They start bringing bags full of Havaianas to spread among their friends, the other friend, model friends. So we found out that it was happening like that. And people was using Havaianas on the fashion shows in Milan, in Paris, in Tokyo, in New York, in Los Angeles. So, wow, this is something really organic happening. So we are really big in Brazil, a hip brand in Brazil. And then the models start spreading the product. And everybody was traveling abroad, was bringing Havaianas. And the client had a very nice idea. When we have a World Cup, I don't remember which one, I think it's what, 98, we put the flag, the Brazilian flag on the Havaianas. So Havaianas became kind of a Brazilian standard, a Brazilian flag traveling all over the world. So people were using Havaianas with the Brazilian flag. It was a Brazilian brand from the beginning. And it happened organically. We didn't plan exactly to work like that, but this is just the power of the brand in the country. Became so powerful that spread the flag and the symbols all over the place. Then what we started doing was, we did, for instance, a campaign for the first fashion magazine. I don't remember exactly the title it was at that time. International magazine. We put the ads in Portuguese. Very colorful, beautiful. But I convinced the client to put the ads in Portuguese. Because if you put the ads in Portuguese, people are gonna look at this colorful sandal, this visual explosion of color, and very Brazilian, tasty and colorful. In Portuguese, people won't understand that word, but it's gonna be really, really Brazilian. And it worked out. So the clients start having sales representatives, start opening offices in Australia, in Europe, in the US, and then exploded. And it became the first truly Brazilian brand. As I said in the beginning, we started together in the strategy, in the development of the campaign, and what should we do? We're sitting together. That happened all the time. We had this very close relationship. Every single discussion about something that's going to happen to the brand, we were invited. We have discussions, we would say, we don't agree with that, let's discuss this and so on. Once in a while, the client did some research, and we did happen to talk about research and what the findings are, how we're gonna change that and change or keep something or change something. It was very nice. As I told before, success is the best glue between a client and an agency. So we were very successful, and then everybody really liked the work. And the client realized that if they would leave the agency, they wouldn't find this capability, this visual and this understanding of the brand that we had. So we work together. So I can tell you a lot of examples when we have discussions about the new collections, and we have some sayings in that. We designed some products inside the agency. We brought ideas to the agency, to the client, about how to design the product in a different way. And sometimes they use that. One of the most successful products they had was one that we have some colors in the stripes. It was really, really a nice, interesting way of working together. And there was, for instance, we commercial in Brazil that was very funny about an old lady talking about sex. And it was very Brazilian kind of humor. And it didn't strike well in some parts of the country. And we get a lot of backlash. And we sit together and we saw, and the client, Carla Schmitzberger at that time, she was very brave in understanding and say, the message was clear. You want to talk to young people. And that's the message that we talk, is right. We didn't make any mistakes. People that don't like the commercials are not the people that are buying this product exactly, but what should we do? And then I talk on the meeting, you say, let's do a commercial about with the old lady talking about holding the Havaianas and talking. I talked about sex and some people didn't like it. Okay, people don't like me talking about sex, it's fine. I respect that. So we don't use the commercials on TV anymore, but you like to see me again, this is my website. Let's talk about sex on my website and I show you the product. It was a way of responding to the public, but taking a stand. And this is, it's only happened when the client and the agency are working together in the same meeting, discussing the strategy together. And that happened many, many, many times. So I think that was one of the best relationships we had with clients in the agency in our history. Trust happens when you tell the truth. If you don't try to, if you look in the eye of the client and tell, oh, I failed here, I made a mistake, let's correct that together. Or, and the client has the same ability to talk to you and say, okay, I think this direction is not good enough, or let's change together. Trust is about honesty and about being honest with each other. And we develop a kind of, as an agency, we didn't pretend much. We were very open. When we are successful, when we made a mistake, and when we didn't know exactly what to do, and we say, I don't know exactly what to do, let's keep me 2 days and I'm going to figure it out and bring in a solution and so on. Very honest. We never pretend. And sometimes agencies try to pretend a little bit to try to develop the trust. My clients, you know, maybe it's a Brazilian thing. We are very, I wouldn't say affectionate, but I would say very open to each other. We don't have this business. If you go to the business meeting in Brazil, you go to the bank, you go to the agency or the client among Brazilians, we talk about 15, 20 minutes about bullshit, about family life, about struggles, about beach, about surf, about weather, whatever. We talk a lot about personal things inside a meeting. That's the way we actually do meetings, do business. We talk in the eye and we have this kind of trust building conversations in the beginning, because Brazilians like to do business with someone they trust. And to find trust, they have to connect chemically in the meeting before you go straight to the business, is rational and bah, let's do it. This is the way of Brazilian. That's why I like. I'm living in Hawaii for the last 5 years. And every time I come here, now I'm in São Paulo. Every time I come here, you talk to the taxi driver. We start the same kind of relationship. You're going to drive me for half an hour. I'm going to pay you $50. But before you do that, let's start talking. So it's always develop this kind of relationship. I think in instant friendships that happens in 10 minutes and won't last, but in these 10 minutes are somehow intense. And that's the way how you build trust. And Alpargatas is a 100% Brazilian brand, and we are 100% Brazilian, so it happened like this. First, we have to understanding the brand is not only knowing exactly where the brand wants to go, but try to find out where the brand comes from. And understand the history of the brand, understand the idea behind the brand creation, what was in the beginning, the first DNA, and try to stick to the truth of the brand that was in the past and try to make it alive. So that's, for me, is people trying to create stories about brands out of nowhere sometimes, because they found there is a niche in the market for this kind of history story to develop, or to, it's a niche that we can actually go in there. It's more about the goal than about being true to yourself. Try to find an idea or a brand, some kind of idea in the brand that actually is powerful enough that if you put out there, you're gonna find the niche that was looking for. It's not very easy, but it's very interesting to be truth to your, today, if you don't talk about truth, you are dead. If you try to make some kind of stories and marketing stories, it's gonna be dead. And the most difficult part today is to convince a client that you have to be steady. You have to have one kind of brand message. Because today, with the social media, the diffraction of the media is so over the place. You have so many options to touch people that brands and agencies trying to get different messages for different kind of groups. And at the end, you have a kind of mess up idea of the brand. I think try to find the truth and stick to it. It's very difficult for the clients to believe in that, because they change marketing directors all the time. And every time a new marketing director comes, it tries to find a new truth about the brand, a new direction, a new aim, so they can actually have the ownership of this new direction in case it's going to be successful. But to be successful, you have to be steady. I always understood that when the client, the CEO, the marketing director, the board are tired of the message of, oh, I cannot hear the CEOs anymore. I think that's the time, that's the moment when the audience start to realizing or listen to our message. So it's a really, people don't care about brands. And nowadays they care even less. So you have to be steady, you have to be consistent, so that people actually realize, oh, this brand stands for that. Oh, and I like it, or I don't like it. But you have to be steady.